بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome to 502 Model College. The subject is Social Studies, Class 7th. The topic is Provincial System of Government during Mughal Empire. For administrative purposes, the Mughal emperors divided their kingdom into provinces. Extension of kingdom caused an increase in the number of provinces. Provincial system of the Mughals is described below. Number one is Subedar or Governor. In every province, one Subedar was appointed who was in charge of civil as well as army matters. Usually, some prince or emperor's confidant was made subedar. His functions included the following. That is, maintaining law and order in the province, punitive action against rebels, helping famine affected population, providing troops to the emperor in the time of need, providing justice and supervising his subordinates. His tenure was subject to will of the emperor. Number two, Diwan. A Diwan was appointed in every province on behalf of center. He was in charge of financial matters. He has to maintain the records of income and expenditure. And report to emperor or central Diwan about financial situation of the province. Number three, Sadar. Sadaral Sadur appointed a Sadar in each province who was in charge of religious affairs. His functions were to appoint Imams and Muezzins, financial help of religious scholars, management of pensions for teachers and students, supervising the seminaries, eradicating any anti-faith elements, he was also superintendent of Justice Department. Number 4, Bakshi. Bakshi was head of troops stationed in his province. Payment of salaries to the troops, recruitment of soldiers and supervision of military expeditions were also his duties. Number 5. Kotwal. A Kotwal was appointed . He was the head of police force . His functions and responsibilities were to maintain law and order and monitoring the criminals, along with that, guarding the prison . Elimination of brothels, taking action against drug trafficking, implementing the decisions of Qazis. These were his responsibilities. Number 6. Historiography. He was responsible for dispatching important reports and news to the center. informing about law and order situation, monitoring the officials, and reporting them to the emperor. Number 7, Potadar. An officer of treasury was appointed in each province that was called Fortadar. He collected revenue from cultivators and issued them receipts as well as maintain the records of income and expenditure. He was not authorized to spend any amount without prior approval from Diwan. Number 8, Faujdar. Faujdar was an army official . He was also the commander of troops in his area . His functions was to take action against rebels and control the crimes. Number 9, Amil. Chief officer of Pagana was called Amil. His functions were collecting of revenue from the cultivators . Deciding about administrative affairs of Pargana, measuring cultivable lands . Examining the registers of land record holders, that is called Patwari, and revenue officer facilitator called Mukaddam. Basically, students, these are the types of government which even we can see nowadays . In other words, Pargana is nowadays called as district council. At that time, it was named as Pargana. Nowadays, it is called district council. Number 10, Butukchi. Amel of East Pargana had a counterpart named Butukchi. He was responsible for preparing annual accounts, statements of revenue, and maintaining regular records of the land. Kanun go, Mukaddam, and Patwari were his subordinates. Number 11, Sarkar. Provinces were further divided into Sarkars . This mayor was taken to deter any insurrection in the provinces . Two main officers were appointed in Sarkar. They were number 1, Chikdar. This official was responsible for law and order in the province, and for this purpose a small troop was dedicated under him. He was to control the rebels in his area. Enforce official orders and monitoring the Chikdar of Pargana. Number 12, The second official is called Munsif. He performed his duties in Sarkar as a judge. Hearing civil suits, appointment of munsifs in Pargana, and monitoring their work was his responsibility. His additional duty was to settle any dispute among Parganas regarding boundaries. Number 12 is Pargana. Each Sarkar was subdivided into Parganas . Each Pargana consists of many villages. Five officers were appointed in each Pargana to administer local affairs. Number 1, Sikdar. Maintained law and order in Pargana. Second is Munsif. His duty was to perform judgment in Pargana. Third is Muqaddam, also known as Amin. His duty was to collect revenue in Pargana. Number 4, Potadar. His duty was to collect revenue in Pargana. Number 5, Kanun Go. Maintained the records of cultivable lands. Then number 13, villages. One chowkidar, you may call it watchman, patwari, land record assistant, and Mukaddam, facilitator, was appointed in every village . Watchman was responsible for keeping an eye on thieves . He served at night. Watchmen for his village . Patwari maintained the records of land and prepare estimate of revenue demand, whereas Mukaddam collected the revenue and deposited it in treasury. There was also a panchayat in every village which included prominent local personalities. They were responsible for settling local disputes and provide relief to oppressed ones. Dear students, read it again. Take care of your health. Stay at home. Stay healthy. Thank you very much. Stay blessed.